Hello viewer, welcome to my YouTube channel Nigeria Politics. We focus on political matters happening in and around agriculture in Nigeria. For first time viewers, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel by clicking the red button below. Also, hit on the bell button so you will always get notifications when a news story drops. Here's today's headline. My supposed quarrel with Oshiomole is fake news. The story reads, Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki has described the alleged infraction between him and his predecessor and National Chairman of the party, Comrade Adams Oshiomhole, as fake news. Obaseki, who also spoke on the second term bid form the first time, says whether he gets a second term in the office or not depends entirely on God and the people of Edo State, especially on how much they think he has impacted their lives. The Edo State governor, who spoke with newsmen on Sunday night in Abuja shortly after attending a meeting of the Progressive Governors Forum, however, did not elaborate on the two issues. When asked about the infraction, Obaseki simply said, "There is no infraction between me and the national chairman of the party. It's all in the press. It's all fake news." There has been reports in the media in recent times of a crisis between the governor and his former boss, with many insinuating it got to a head when the governor failed to show up for annual Okepe 10-kilometer race in May. Sources close to the governor confirmed the intervention of the president on the alleged crisis, saying, "The president called them and they have been talking. I can tell you there's nothing serious going on between them, really." Asked about his second term bid, the governor, who was believed to be the engine room of Oshiomole's governance in Edo State, simply said, "My second term is left to God and the people of Edo State. At the end of the day, the people will decide depending on how much they see that we have added value to their lives. I have things like industrialization, ensuring economic growth by building production centers, industrial parks, and ensuring that government service as enabler. That is the key for us. So we have been spending time improving the business climate so that people can do business more easily in the state. Hopefully, that will have a snowball effect on the region. I promise to create 200,000 jobs in our first 4 years in office. And at the last count, we have exceeded 90,000 and we are still counting. As you are aware, these jobs are coming in from various aspects of industries, technology, ICT, education, the services, and now we are investing in production hubs where we bring electricity, water, and security into specific locations and invite people to come and set up in those particular locations. What are we doing, which is different and which we are very excited about, is education reform, particularly basic education reform in Edo State. We have trained over 10,000 teachers in our basic education system. We have introduced technology. Now we can track when teachers are in class. We can track when students are in class, and for about 200,000 kids in our basic schools, we have supplied them almost 1 million books. Please drop a message below. Thank you."